In Imbuzi Ward in Fort Porto North Division, a savings group was found slaughtering a cow they started saving for since January. The meat was shared for the big day tomorrow. The group, which calls itself Nyakagogo Nyachitokori Tumuche Group, has a total of 150 members. According to Kanyiginya Monica, the group's chairperson, for the past 5 years they have been slaughtering a cow for Christmas. Meanwhile, in Kagadi district, meat sellers and transporters have decried losses incurred during this season brought about by the low sales. Meat sellers have slaughtered between 30 to 40 heads of cattle compared to the previous Christmas when they slaughtered between 80 to 100 heads of cattle. Boda boda riders say the hike in fuel prices has seen them make losses.
I made a tatembia of one just caro Hano Town service in Kumukumi, Rikera Savas, Travila Bay, and Kawakirova Kizuka COVID-19.
Residents said although Christmas celebrations have changed since COVID hit the country, they are glad to continue with the tradition.
Tomorrow's day is quite different from the rest of the days. I know we have been enjoying meat all along, but today's and tomorrow's, it is quite different because as a person, me have bought 10 kilograms for my family of about 8 members. So it is quite different and I'm very, very excited, very happy, and I guess I understand my family members, my biological children, the family members, together with the neighbors, because this is really a day of enjoyment.
About meat, this is a norm. It is a norm as a responsible husband and a parent. I had to fulfill my obligation. I bought meat, I bought chicken, whatever is really required. I've done, I've played my part. So I would also encourage other parents and husbands, family heads, to really do the same.
Geoffrey Businge, the Kagadi Town Council OC3 chairman, urged residents to spare money for school fees.
I also call upon Ugandans that as they spend, they should bear in mind that school fees is coming. You know, children are going back to school and they will need a lot of money, and therefore as we spend, let us ensure that we also save some good money to enable us as parents to take our children back to school.
Story compiled by Jonan Tusingwile and Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.